enemies do they think the Super Bowl?
Yeah, he's two Westfield coaches on the Falcons coaching staff. So I went to open the night and interviewed them. A former Westfield coach. One was at Westfield last year. So, yeah, he's there as a coaching intern or an offensive assistant. So I did that. And I think I'm covering the game or helping cover the game. So.
Cool.
Yeah, looking forward to it. There's a madhouse down there.
Yeah, look. I don't
want
to go.
Nobody wants to stay. Nobody wants part of that, man. Traffic is crazy.
I'm happy, happy, happy.
Yeah, I'm not regretting my decision to not work the game.
Yeah.
Especially I won't be regretting it. Right when the game ends, I'm sitting in my chair.
Oh, man. And I, sit waiting in a parking lot for something.
Well, that was the thing. Like, so when we did the stats for the last one, they had us there 6 hours early so we could go through screening and get ahead of the curve. So you're sitting there for 6 hours. And you do the game, and then afterwards, wait to get out of there, and they still in the carpool, and you go to the place where you met, took that your carpool, and then you finally drive off. The really funny part was, it wasn't until I got in the car and turned on the radio that I found out about Janet Jackson. The whole time being at the game, I had no clue before Twitter. So it happened, but we weren't watching TV, so we didn't know, and it never came into the step room. Hey, guess what happened? On the radio, I'm like, what the hell? I had set a DVR, I mean my VHS, and I went home and I rolled it back. Oh, my. That's a little different.
Yeah. Wardrobe malfunction.
Yeah. Wardrobe malfunction, that's right.
There's something where they go like, there's a 10-second kill switch. Or...
Yeah, that was a nice.
How do you say you won't pay them?
Nice one, needed to save you.
Right?
Mm-hmm. Will not get your check at the end of the game if there's a wardrobe malfunction. I just don't know how that helps sell albums.
There's a lot of that.
A lot of things in the world.
Yeah, because we don't use it. Then tell you something, we don't sweat. Everybody figures something out. If it's a slow
day. The person to turn around slow day. Way, but I just don't know what it
is. So Chuck, just tell me what
it is. It's cold.
Hmm?
It's cold. Soft.
It should be. It's where money is. Yes. Sadly, I'll hear it coming down.
Is that your Easter shirt?
Yeah, since I was 14 years old. You didn't hear what I just told you.
You think I'd ask that if I hadn't heard?
Nah, you're asked.
Did you buy that from Underwear?
Yeah. It's their casual line.
It's their Easter wear.
Clubhouse.
Yeah. That's where their stock was.
This is
their Easter wear 2002. Why not?
Love the shirt.
And it loves you. Boy, it's a good thing we weren't going to the press conference.
Yeah, right? That's not going to be the first time that's ever happened.
I talked to somebody once, didn't I?
Yeah, you did.
How many years ago was that?
No.
Big press conference, phone rang, but I just answered it.
Your phone?
No, what man?
Somebody
phone and piss.
I said, hello.
Great moments in Super Bowl hosting history. Right here.
Yeah. I'll cancel your signing party at lunch. Yeah. We found out Friday night at 8:30.
Yeah.
If they didn't just told us up front, we could have paid for
it. Yeah.
All kinds of arrangements. Couldn't have let sugar
screw. We're happy to have you here. Happy to be a good part of the Houston community.
Yeah.
AKA, thank you, sir, man. Another.
Moving in where I was getting ready to go.
Awesome.
G out of Texas high schools.
Okay.
So they won't, because they keep smarter than kids.
Sure.
So all the high school coaches are pretty much fully out of G.
That's interesting.
No, we'll go on the global game type thing. Well, I know the coaches in Louisiana are not really happy. I mean, no coaches are happy with it, right?
Right, none. And so the Under Armour All-American Bowl has turned into nothing but IMG reps trying to meet those kids.
Which is why I asked. That was the only one they had.
Do they still do the combine thing, the same as the US Army game?
That's the Army's pulled out.
From a sponsorship standpoint?
Something's changing there. But IMG's trying to take the kids. So they can't get access to the state.
So they're waiting until they get.
Well, I guess my thing with that is, like, how many do you need?
Well, yeah, that's not the objective. That's not the objective.
The guy said they don't have a win state championship until they took his quarterback.
Right.
I mean, I've got buddies who. I have a buddy who has a kid at UI in Baton Rouge, Dylan Moses, who's like one of the top 5-ranked recruits in the country. He jetted last January. My boss's son played in Georgetown last year, and he's a deep snapper, the only deep snapper in the country. And he went to IMG. So.
This was a kid here in the state.
Pardon?
His kid here in the state, right? The deep snapper?
Yeah.
Yeah, because they're not very happy about that either.
The guy from Georgia?
Yeah.
State.
They're a buzz right now on
keep his back.
Coaches go. That's like when primetime started the academy in Dallas. We had a poor kid came to our camp last year, had a 32 on his ACT, and then they wouldn't give him credited hours out of that prep school. And so he couldn't go to, what school was it? John, I remember. He couldn't go because they had, that you had to be a high school grad from the time.
Right.
And he was sorry because of the prep. Goodness. Everything down.
Well, I guess we can go ahead and go with this. And when you ditch her afterwards, you can just stand up or you.
I'm just worried about these two guys. They got time to do it too.
I don't want her to get here and you not be here. You know what I'm saying?
The green lightness? Get everything plugged in the right place, Chad?
Yes, sir. Good.
Now I'm going to stop recording. I'm going to re-record because.
Hey, appreciate y'all coming today. I know it's a busy day in Houston, and for you guys to make the time to get here, it's really special. And it's been a special day for Rice. We signed 17 young men today that we're extremely, extremely excited about. We think their future's bright. I think they make our future bright. 15 of them are from the great state of Texas. Eight of them are offensive linemen. Four of them are offensive linemen. Eight of them are from the Houston area is what I meant to say. Two are from Dallas area, two from Austin, two from the Golden Triangle, one from Corpus Christi, one from Indiana, and one from Canada. So we dipped back into Canada and found a young man. They're very talented. They have a lot of talents other than just playing football. Six of them are National Honor Society members. Five more of them are academic all-state. They've won numerous academic awards. You got the Island Math Achievement Award. You got scholar designate from Canada, which is a National Honor Society. You got a young man that was a finalist at the Touchdown Club here in Houston as a scholar athlete. They got three academic all districts. Total of 13 of them have won academic awards. We're really excited about that. We've got one of them is a world class bagpipe player that we have some great video. He's learning the Rice fight song. Right now, he's also 6'5", 350, so the backpacks look very small. One of them is a classical guitarist, an electric guitarist. So there's a lot of talent, but in addition to being great students, they're great athletes that we truly believe we'll be able to win championships with. As I said, 13 of these 17 guys have been with us since last summer. So they gave us their word last summer. They stayed committed through thick and thin. I think it says a lot about their character. I think it says a lot about the hard work that this coaching staff put in to recruit a class like this that's this athletic. We think it's a class that can win its championships, and we think it's a class that can have 100% graduation rates. They are great fits at Rice University. Four of the young men that we've signed this year was an offensive lineman. It was a need. We needed to grow our numbers there, and we also needed some size. The first young man I'll talk about is Shea Baker. Shea came in, and he was 6'3", 275 pounds, and the beautiful thing is that he has size 18 feet. He's a true earth mover. He's very athletic. Unbelievable student, great players, all state. We have Gregor McKellar, the young man from Canada, 6'5", 350. And when you watch his video of what he does and how he moves people off the line of scrimmage and how light he is on his feet, we really think this guy is going to be the limit. We have Brant Peterson out of Hyde Park in Austin, who's a tight end right now. He's 6'7", 250. Undersized, a young man that we're going to have to develop, but you watch 2 or 3 years from now, he'll be that 6'5", 320-pound offensive tackle. And Corbin Smith, a young man from Nederland, who's one of those. He's 6'4", 320 right now, and they're still just growing young men. Not a heavy beard on any of those four, which is the first thing a coach looks for when he walks into an offensive lineman's house is he shaving yet? If he's not shaving, that's pretty good news for us. The quarterback we signed, Miklo Smalls, is the MVP of his district. He was the offensive MVP last year as a junior. He actually had over 7,600 total yards in his career. Great basketball player, great leader, heavily involved in the community. Really excited that he has joined us. He's a guy that can make plays with his mind. He makes them with his arm. He makes them with his feet. Extending plays, extremely athletic. Same three wide receivers. Chris Boudreaux would be the first one. He's a high school quarterback from Beaumont Central that we're going to move to receiver. Very athletic. He's right on the cusp of really being a good quarterback. We'll be able to pull off some double passes and some different things with him. He's going to make the game a lot of fun. And then we've taken Cameron Montgomery. Cameron Montgomery is a young man that actually won the state championship last year in the 100 meter. He was in the 10-4s. He believes that he can hit the high 10-3s this year. And he's a dynamic player. He's a punt returner. He really makes great things happen when the ball's in his hand. And to get that type of speed, it's really exciting. And then Austin Trammell, a young man here in town from Klein, his senior year was cut a little short with injury. He came to our camp last year and was just dynamic. It was a young man we really didn't know a lot about. And then you just watched him. He caught everything we threw. He was very precise in his routes. And just from a fabulous family, one that's going to be a great fit here for us at Rice. Linebackers. We got Garrett Grammer from Rosenberg, Richmond Foster. They were 14-1 this year. He was actually a finalist for the Defensive Player of the Year in the city of Houston. He was an all-state player, just tremendous numbers, tremendous hitter. Can really tackle in open fields, got sideline to sideline speed. And he's one that, we're really excited about. Then we have Randall Royal, the other linebacker. His granddad actually played football at Rice, and he's another one. He's kind of more of an old school type linebacker that when he hits you, it's really a hat back tackle and can get you going the wrong way. fast. If you watch his video, you'll see he is very disruptive, extremely secure tackler. Then excited that he is coming and is going to join us. It just continues, you know, to get better around here with who we're recruiting. We had a late recruit come in, Kenneth Orgy from Elkins, who we picked up right at the end, and he's a great player, great linebacker. He'll play outside linebacker for us, and he's a dominant player, led his team in tackles, another old district player. We took three defensive backs this year. Isaiah Richard, another young man from Foster, Tyree Thornton, the young man from Cy Ridge, and George Nyquil, a young man from Old Dean Eisenhower. All of these defensive backs are over 6 foot tall, and they're playmakers. And they all they're all courageous to where they tackle, they hit, they intercept. Tyree returns kickoffs, returns punts, so they're very versatile in what they do. You know, we'll have to look at some of these guys fast, just where we are in numbers. George Nyquil is also a 48-foot triple jumper. He'll have a chance to win the state championship this year in the triple. An amazing kid. In the front, we signed one young man from Burleson, Trey Schumann. He's 6'3", 280. And he is absolute a disruptive force when he comes off the football. You see him in his stance. He's extremely flexible in his ankles and his hips. Flat backed in that stance, when he comes off, he really disrupts the line of scrimmage and has exceptional speed for his size. Excited about him. The kicker that we have is, we went to Indiana and found the kicker, Will Harris. You know, we just thought we needed to come in and get some competition going at that position. He was a high school All-American there, and just, you know, we can see him competing for the starting job immediately. And then I don't want to leave out our tight end, Jager Bull from Corpus Christi. He was a high school quarterback, very productive high school quarterback, very athletic, but he's a young man that we're going to start at tight end and see where he goes. You know, high school coaches always put their finest athlete at the quarterback position, and that's why you see so many of them, you know, on our rosters. And then Jager right now is 6'4", 220 pounds, and he's a young man that came to camp and offered, committed early to us, and hung with us. So it's an exciting time. It's an exciting class. You know, hopefully we'll get them here in June, before they go to summer school. And we're going back again to work recruiting our next class tomorrow. Any questions?
Coach, talk a little bit more about Kenneth. He was a late addition, like you said, but it just seemed like a really nice cherry on top of his class. And kind of what?
Yeah, you know, that was one. It was really amazing. You know, he had been recruited by some really nice schools, and was trying to commit, waited too long, and so we got in on him late because he was having so many people recruiting. And then we had actually lost a young man, so the timing of it, we really think we one of those times where you get fortunate, you may have traded up. Very athletic playmaker, you can see all his numbers there. And he's a four-time academic all-district selection. He's a tall kid, broad shoulders, runs extremely well, and his production's off the chart. So we think, you know, we hit a home run there late, adding him to our class.
Coach, you mentioned about the offensive line, the guys you talked about. They're more set up for depth than as far as competing for the job from day one.
Offensive linemen need to redshirt. We have next season about 8 starters back in the offensive line because of the injury we've had. Okay. So we have nice numbers there, nice guys that have played in games and lettered. So I think we'll have the luxury to redshirt these guys and let them grow and get that fifth year where they're really special players.
Coach, when you have a situation like this one with the Super Bowl and the NFL, they throw down some new turf in there for you, so like there's some benefits. Can you talk to me just about like some of the, you know, they're going to pack up and leave after Sunday, but then, you know, this is something that you guys get you know, the NFL gives. So just talk about the benefit of having something like that.
The field is unbelievable what they've done for us, and I think the NFL and I guess the Falcons won it, but it's been wonderful having them. It's wonderful for the city of Houston. One where we're sharing a building with them, and we're more than happy that they're there. And the field was a very nice trade-off. We are over here today because they're practicing, so that's one of the trade-offs that we've had to make. But what they're doing and what they're leaving behind is really going to help Rice football.
And you mentioned that help because when you're showing off a recruit everything, it impacts future recruiting classes, right? They can see this, and they're like, wow, this is pretty awesome. You got new everything, right? You got new facility.
Yeah, you know what's crazy is our field was in pretty good shape. So that wouldn't have been the first thing on the wish list, but that's what they did. And they took something good and made it great, so I'm for that.
Wide receivers and some of these DBs, a lot of athletes, two sport kids. That's a helpmate more than it is a hindrance, and most of you guys in track. How much was that a point of emphasis when you all started your recruitment trail and all this past season?
You know, we really like young men that play a lot of sports. I think it shows a mental toughness. I think it shows a grit. You really love those guys that compete in track right now that are trying to increase their speed. The things where we always have to start at RISO before we get excited about their athleticism is we start in the counselor's office. It's just what we have to do here. And so we don't ever get the cart before the horse. And that's, the one thing about these kids, and I said this last year, they truly do all have five-star minds. You know, these are brilliant young men who are true student athletes, and that's what is so exciting, that you have the ability to coach young men like this who want to compete and win championships, but who also want to compete in the classroom and graduate. And fortunately, I've said this many times too, we're coaching the future leaders of this country, and they are wonderful men from wonderful families. And you know, I like what was into recruiting, especially at Rice. I think the first thing you have to do, these kids are our family treasures. All our children are our treasures. And I think so much has to go in there, parent to coach and parent to parent, that there has to be trust established there that we're going to help these young men grow and develop as students, as players, as men. And that's what we call them, the total package guys, because that's what they are.
Coach, no real running back in this class. I know Cameron plays a running back in high school, but you guys so comfortable there. I know Sam Stewart is coming back.
Well, we have quite a few, like Emmanuel Asuka. We have some running backs you really hadn't had a chance to see yet. So it was a year. All the scholarships are on a formula of how many positional you need to get to the 85, and this was just a year we were at that number of running back.
It seems like these things, you've been through the recruiting process enough times, but does it ever get used to having to sit down, have dinner with one family, get up, have dinner with another family a couple hours later? Like, does you ever adjust to that, doing something?
I love what I do, number one. I absolutely love being a college football coach. I love having the ability to go into these young men's home and get to know their parents and get to know their brothers and sisters. And so there's always an excitement, actually, when you walk in there. It's not a job I take for granted. It's one where every home you go in there, there's something that you're learning. George Nyquil, for instance, his family story is so amazing. His parents are so amazing, that they immigrated from Sudan and they're living the true American dream. And it makes you really almost glow inside that you're making young men's life dreams come true when you offer them a scholarship to Rice. And you see the excitement, in the mom and dad's face and in their family's face, and that you're going to make a difference for them the next 40 or 50 years. And that's just an exciting time. And, there's usually some great food, too, when you do those home visits. They make sure they feed you well.
Coach, Miklo Smalls, I talked to his high school coach earlier today, and of course he raved about him. But is this a kid that has a chance to jump into the starting conference? competition in the summer. I know we're way ahead of ourselves, but.
Well, you know what? That's his intention. Yeah. You know, he has told us he's going to come in here and he wants to compete. And when you see how he handles himself as a young man and the confidence that he has in his game, you know, I know he's going to come in and study and he's going to try to do just that. And once you look at his numbers, just the last 2 years of what he's been able to do with his arm and his feet, that's a pretty productive young man. So we look forward to, like I said, getting him here in June and see what he can do.
I know, speaking to Kent earlier, of course, you guys got Ryan Stewart and switching defenses. So how much did that change things, or do you guys feel like you already have pieces that guys that can adjust?
I think we have the pieces or we wouldn't have done it.
Yeah.
You know, you do things to make yourself better. I thought that was, we need to be better defensively. I thought with defensive ends like Brad Womack, Grayson Shines, those type of players, that they're really, they can stand up as easy as they put the hand on the ground. You know, I thought too, it was just time for us to change what we did structurally, where we could give offenses more things to look at. And I'm really excited Brian Stewart's here right now, running our defense. You'll have a chance to meet him soon. You know, it's nice to sit in really a room. It makes me learn some things. You know everything in the world about the 4-2-5, but there's a lot to learn when it's the 3-4. And so it's been good for all of us to learn that.
Does it help, I mean, to be able to kind of sell that? Because you guys are already selling a very successful coaching staff. To be able to say to a recruit, hey, look, our new defensive coordinator coached in the NFL. I mean, you know, like we can, it has to add something, right?
Absolutely. I mean, when he coached for the Texans, you know, he's been the defensive coordinator for the Dallas Cowboys. I think that's exciting to young men to know that he knows what it takes to get in the NFL and to work there, and that he's going to be able to develop them with some of those same drills that he's used for the Texans and the Cowboys.
Coach, I believe, was this the first class you guys got a chance to show the recruits the facilities when they were done? Because I think last year, maybe they weren't done.
Yeah. Right. Yeah. Actually, I guess our first 9 years here, we showed this plan.
But this is the first time that it was finished.
And that helped a lot. Brian Patterson has done, you know, that was a big reason, too, I think, that we attracted this type of student-athlete. We're able to retain him. Because there's a lot of guys that tried to turn these young men, and they stuck with us. And I think a new facility had a lot to do with that.
You guys had two tight ends early on, now just one. You talked to me about recruiting multiple tight ends. You feel like that's a need, or, you know?
Well, if you look at our roster as it's falling, we need to get some numbers there.
Yeah.
You know, we just graduated one last year. We brought in Jonathan, who's a gray shirt, who's here now on campus. But we needed some numbers at that position, and we need to get some guys that can really put their hand on the ground. And, you know, I think you need to tie it in your offensive set here.
I know you guys probably don't care about rankings, but does that ever come up? You know,
beauty's in the eyes of the beholder. And last I checked, we had 8 guys in the NFL. So I don't know who ranks them, but I don't believe it's football coaches.
Well, let me ask this question then. Extend it on that.
My mom could pick a 5-star. I don't know how in the world does a 4-3 one.
But
jeez.
Does it resonate more with recruits when they know that the school they are attending that's recruiting them has players in the NFL that's playing?
Sure,
on
absolutely.
A regular basis.
And 7 of 8 of them have graduated. You know, and so that resonates well with moms too. You know, so it truly is a place you can come here and all your dreams can come true.
It seems like you guys get a lot of 2-star guys. They have that chip on their shoulder because they know they're 2-star guys. And they use that. Do you sense that from recruits?
Sure. You know what we have, all the guys that are in the NFL, and that that's 8 active right now. Yeah. You know, that doesn't include Solomon and Jared Dillard and mm-hmm. James Casey's. They've been the hardest workers from the day they got here. You know, they're 2-stars that just work. And they've been the hardest workers in our program, and that's what got them there. They've just continued to develop. You know, sometimes they don't come here with egos. They come here and they know that working hard works.
I know you guys are always heavy on redshirted guys and guys kind of waiting in the wings, but is it a case-by-case basis when you get all these recruits on campus? So how do you handle that?
It is. You know, we've tried to redshirt everybody in the past, had the injury bug the last 2 years, so I'm really, I think we'll probably look at a lot of these guys this year as possibly playing heavy roles in special teams where we don't get caught in short numbers late in the year. Thank you, man. Thank you, young lady.
All right.
Thanks, Sarah. All right. Warren, Nick.
Thanks, Coach.
Sorry, you're not Nick, that's your brother. Brian?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
And
really good.